Can you convert my STL into a step file? I heard this question too many times, and people tend to believe that a conversion from a facetized model to a full parametric CAD data is simple and quick. Facetized models like STLs consist in a bunch of facets meshed from a point cloud, whereas a fully parametric CAD data is defined by mathematical surfaces, blends, holes, and freeforms like UV surfaces. Converting an STL into a parametric model is called reverse engineering because you have to redesign a CAD file using a partial dataset from a 3D scanner, for example. How much time does it take? It depends on the geometry. It depends on what you want to do with the CAD model. Welcome to this NX Insight. I am Alexis Capoen from JANUS Engineering, and in this video, you will understand how to obtain a proper CAD data from a facetized model in an efficient way.
The STL format is widely used in the field of 3D printing because it has the advantage of being light and compatible with many digital platforms. 3D scanners also export data in STL format, since they collect points in space and triangulate them to obtain the shapes of the real model. When you choose to work with STL all the way in Siemens NX, you can use convergent modeling to directly modify the facets of your model. You can repair it if it has facet errors, or smooth it to improve the surface quality. You can also directly add geometric functionalities, such as blends, or additional thickness. For instance, this smoothing function is very useful to get rid of orange peel effect. To go further, you can even use advanced features, such as morphing. But this is not exactly the topic of today. Keep in mind that even if convergent modeling tools are very powerful to work with STL files, it will always be easier for you to parameterize in depth real CAD data using synchronous modeling. In short, when you export data, prefer step or parasolid format when possible. But again, this is not the topic of today. Scanned STL data is sometimes difficult to manage when you want to use it to rework the model in depth. It is therefore necessary to use reverse engineering methods. This process consists of properly redesigning a CAD file, partially or completely, based on the scanned data. The tools and methods to use depend on the geometry to build. For prismatic shapes, the feature detection makes it possible to quickly generate parametric surfaces, such as planes or cylinders, for instance, with dimension recognition. For more complex shapes, such as this gear, dimension detection and constraint is mandatory to design a functional model in order to overcome the possible wear and deformation of a long-used part. In this example, the main conical shape is generated from the average of all gear teeth. Keep in mind that when you create a surface, you will always have a deviation between this surface and the STL file. This deviation will depend on the part wear level, but also on the scanner resolution. For fewer versions, AI is progressively implemented in Siemens NX. This leads to an intelligent facet selection method, which can automatically recognize even freeform regions. The final merging of the surfaces leads to the final CAD model, which can be compared to the initial scan data for analysis purpose. In the case you have to work on more complex scan data like tube or revolution shape, you can use the algorithmic modeling to automatically extract the section curves of your profile. The algorithmic module is a newly integrated module in NX CAD where you can create an algorithm with boxes and links in order to create or modify your geometry, or in this case, to automatize a CAD process. This method can be very effective and quick to implement in your workflow, as you can save your algorithm and you reuse it for future use cases. Reverse engineering also becomes essential when the rest of the process requires real CAD data. The best example is multi-axis machining, where UV surfaces are mandatory to create advanced 5-axis toolpaths. In this case, using STL gives poor results most of the time. By using Realize Shape tool in NX, you can quickly obtain a subdivision model in order to generate milling or cladding toolpaths. This method is extremely fast and can be used on complex shapes. Finally, you can also combine STL and parametric model in your workflow. This is an advantage when you have to repair a part with additive manufacturing process. But we will have the opportunity to talk about this specific application in a future video.
We have seen that converting an STL into a step file can be simple if you use the right tools, the right method, and by keeping in mind that you do not always need to rebuild the whole CAD data, but just focus on the most important part. If you want to discover Siemens NX by yourself, you can access a trial version with a link in the description just below. Don't forget to subscribe to JANUS Engineering YouTube channel so you don't miss the upcoming insights. Thank you for watching and see you later.